guys, Sal here. So almost all of us know at this point that the Galaxy S11 Plus will have a 108 megapixel camera. I saw some of you saying it's just a marketing gimmick. More megapixels doesn't mean better camera, which I totally agree. But we got some more information about this sensor, which reveals that it's not just a marketing gimmick. The Galaxy S11 Plus will indeed rule the smartphone cameras next year, both in daylight and in low light conditions. You see, Ice Universe tweeted this yesterday. I see a lot of people didn't understand it, so let me explain what exactly he meant and why it's such a big deal. Like I've said, megapixels aren't everything when it comes to camera quality. In fact, it's a small cog in a much bigger machine. There are other factors such as sensor size, pixel size, software post-processing, and the quality of the camera lens to consider. So let me briefly explain each of these so you get a better idea. The sensor size is pretty easy to understand. A larger sensor has more area for the light to fall on, equating to a greater ability to gather the light. You see, more the light, the more information the sensor captures. But the thing is, if the megapixel count increases, so do the sensor size. So the sensor size is useful for getting an idea of how much space in the smartphone camera module is consumed by the sensor, but less useful for gauging the total light collection as megapixel counts vary between smartphones. This is where the pixel size comes in, giving a direct measure of how large the individual photo detectors are in the camera sensor. To simply put, the bigger the pixel size, the more light it captures, which increases the image quality, increases the dynamic range, and decreases the noise in low light conditions. That being said, Ice Universe is saying the Galaxy S11 Plus will take 108 megapixel images, but it will not save it in that resolution. Instead, it will convert them into 12 megapixel images using 9:1 binning technology, resulting in the pixel size of 2.4 micrometer or microns. The 2.4 microns is important here. It's the world's biggest pixel size ever put in a smartphone. To give you a comparison, the iPhone 11 Pro and Pixel 4 XL both have 1.4 micron pixel size. Like I've said, the bigger the pixel size, the better. So the 2.4 micron pixel size of the S11 Plus is going to be significantly bigger and will directly result in great low light photos compared to the Pixel 4 and the iPhone 11 Pro. Now, some of you might be wondering that why Samsung is not using the full 108 megapixel images, why they are binning it to 12 megapixels. Well, that's because if they use the full 108 megapixel images, then the pixel size would be 0.8 microns. That would result in bad low light photos, and hence they are binning it to 12 megapixels. So when OnLeaks revealed the first look of the Galaxy S11 Plus, it showed a huge camera rectangle with asymmetrical camera arrangement. Ice Universe quickly pointed out that the rendering is wrong, the real phone won't have this messy camera layout. And today, he tweeted out an image of the Galaxy S11 Plus showing the actual camera arrangement. Now, I'm not really sure if this is the official render or he made it himself, but it looks clean, symmetrical, and way better than what OnLeaks revealed in his renders. We can't see the full layout, but what we can see is the ultra-wide camera, the main camera, and the periscope zoom lens. On the right, we should have a time-of-flight sensor, the flash, and possibly a laser autofocus sensor. Of course, that being said, let me know what you think. Does the camera look better now, or you still don't like the way it looks? Do let me know down in the comments, and as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.